real reason why I only wanted you to speak for 2 or 3 minutes. Because I'm not serving. Do you want to say anything?
Well, yes. I feel like I was just at a mini convention. It was so wonderful to hear everybody's share. Thank you. Thank you for sharing. What was most impactful to me was the wave. 12,000 people.
Yeah.
Went around waving. Yeah. And so, get a little more taste of that. I'd like to do the wave ceremony. I was really moved by the grandfather, the son, and the grandson, because I picture John and our 2 sons up there on the stage.
All right.
And the grandson shared how his grandfather had mentored him, and he had gone out to sell memberships, and after 8 no's, he went home. And he told his grandfather, he got 8 no's. And he said, well, why didn't you go after the 9th person? And I have trouble with rejection. And so that really spoke to me, to never give up. Thanks again.
He went out the next time and got the 9th. I want to share my heart for a couple minutes with you. Being dorm parents was a thrill for us. We really love what we're doing. But this business has been an animal. It's tough. And when you put your credit card on the line and you go in the hole $50, $75 one night, and then it happens repeatedly, you begin to question, are we doing the right thing? But I believe we've turned the corner. And it's exciting to me because I don't want 200-300 people in this room so that I can make a bunch of money and pay ourselves back. I want it so that you can make the money. Because what I want to do is see 200-400 people in this room and make so much money off the interest that people are paying that we can go down to Southern Indiana. We can take retreats as top-level executives. We can invite David Byrd to come in and speak to us. We can do some really special things when we grow this marketplace. And you're the key, because so many of you are here tonight that went to the convention, and if you will just stick with it and stay with us, Mr. Gammon and I will commit to building this marketplace, all of Indianapolis, all of Indiana, and we will help your teams across the nation because we are willing to travel. I want to go to Connecticut. I got a granddaughter there. I want to go to San Diego. I've got a grandson there. I want to go to Illinois. I've got 3 granddaughters there. I want to travel, but I want you to be able to step up and take the leadership here because this is going to explode. The vision statement I read not too long ago about where I want to be and what I want to see, the home on Hilton Head Island for pastors and missionaries to go for R&R, the ministries that I want to be able to continue to do to help people. I saw it going so slowly that when that announcement, January 31st, about Mid-Oceans, I didn't have any questions in my mind where we're going. Because I followed the leaders. And the most impactful thing in the whole convention to me was Darnell Self standing up there, and somebody's already alluded to this, Darnell Self saying, you don't know Mid-Ocean Partners. You don't know them, but I do. You trust me. And he is the most influential guy in as far as his integrity and what he's doing to help people and the whole company. And when Darnell Self stands up there and says, I know them. I trust them. You trust me. Transfer your trust from me to them because we are going somewhere.
Amen.
There are times I want to grab people and just shake them. Yeah. I'm not teasing! This is going to explode. It's going to be an absolute incredible journey for those of you who will stick and stay. And some of you have gone through very difficult times. And some of you aren't even in the business yet, you're kind of, oh boy, this is really weird. Holler and have a great time. You need some of that. You go to your jobs, you don't get this at your jobs. You don't get the recognition at your job. And we need this. And what I really see happening, though, is us banding together. Because if one stays home one night, another stays home another night, another one stays home another night, and our numbers begin to dwindle, everybody loses faith. And they don't believe it's going to happen. I knew it would happen. You know, we've gone from 75 down to 55 now. He got distracted and quit. She got distracted and quit. It does happen. But I really believe that we're ready for this. And the people who don't get it are going to be sorry. In 12 to 24 months, I was amazed. Alan Fernley just seems to be such an incredible individual, so comfortable in his own skin. Lanky, just kind of looks like a football, you know? But a brilliant man. And I really believe that this is the time for us to lock arms together and let's take Indiana, let's take Indianapolis by storm, let's recruit up, let's get the sharpest people we know and bring them here, because how many have been to the convention and you think a little bit about prepaid legal and how good it is, and then you get there and you see all these people that are so sharp and you think, I never dreamt it was like this. You know? Yeah, we do that. Because, why? Because we look at those people and think they're so sharp. If I could take these people that have rejected me and put them into this convention and let them see all these people who are here, and let them see those millionaires as they cross stage and as they line up on stage, they would have a different opinion of our company. I mean, I was sitting next to people and people in front of me who've already earned well over $1 million in prepaid legal. Some are earning $250,000 a year in prepaid legal. They're really not that much different than us. They've just been in a little longer. And you just have to keep doing it, one exposure at a time. And that's really a fantastic thing to think of, just one more exposure, one more exposure, one more exposure, sharing it with more people. I really envision us, we have about 75 people here tonight, but there's no reason why we can't go over 100. When you get excited and we bring a visiting speaker in and they bring in, and you bring in a lot of guests, and those guests sign up and they come back and bring in more guests, it's just gonna explode. And I wanna challenge you, come dress sharply. Come dress anticipating an exciting time and bring people with you and let them know they need to come and dress sharp, because this is a business. We're not playing around here. We want to be able to influence the most influential person that walks in those doors by how well we're dressed. So that's what we want you to do. And just come back every Tuesday, every Thursday, every Tuesday, every Thursday, and in between the times, do the work. Do those 10 core commitments every single day, and it will pay off. I really believe that we're ready for this now, and I really believe that you believe it. And I want to see more people up here as executive directors, as ring earners.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
I'm ready to be introducing Mr. Gamble as a ring earner. Not just an executive director, not just a bronze, but a silver, a gold, a platinum, a ringer. I'm ready for that. And let's all do our part. And this book by Jim Stovall, I've already read it. I couldn't put it down.
Me too.
Talks about belief. We have to believe. And you have to believe in the business and the opportunity, and you have to believe in yourself, just like Mr. Gamble was talking about. You have to believe that you can do it, and you can. I've seen incredible changes in people. When you get Darnell's self up there and you think, man, he's so powerful, he's always been that way. No, he wasn't. He talks about when he first got started in prepaid legal, he was so shy. He didn't want to get up in front of people. He didn't want to speak in front of people. And now he's one of the most powerful speakers I've ever heard. He's passionate. And let's be passionate ourselves about this business. And let's go out and let's really do it together. Let's lock arms and let's just really build Indianapolis so that we... You know, if we get this big enough, we're going to attract so much attention. Alan Fernley, Rip Mason, they're going to come.
Yeah.
Tuesday night, Jeffrey Johnson is coming from Louisville.